Hi friends. Today we're going to talk about my October TBR. If you've been around for a while, you probably know that I don't really do TBR videos, mostly because I am a mood reader, and so creating a TBR and knowing what mood I'm going to be in throughout a month can be challenging. But I am taking on a project in October, along with many other projects that I'm doing in October, but apparently I'm insane. And yeah, so I wanted to talk to you guys about that and give you an idea of what I'm going to be reading in October. So the first thing is readathons. I am a lover of readathons. I will be doing the Booathon Bungo, so just like scary bingo. And that is October 19th through the 31st. And I made myself this cool little bingo sheet so that I can keep up with that. Basically, there's a bingo board with all kinds of different words that can be like spooky things that you may see in a book. And that is hosted by Maddie at the Book Pusher. It's mostly on Twitter and Instagram, but I have it on here so that I can keep up with what I'm reading on those days and if it includes any of these things. I will also be participating in this Booktober readathon, and that is the entire month of October. And while there are, I think, 19 prompts, they recommend that you just do as many as you can. And I want to do all 19 because I'm crazy. And this is my spread for that. What I decided that I want to do for October, because I have a couple of readathons I'm going to do. I don't know if Books and Lala is going to do the Spookathon again this year. Haven't seen a video for it yet. Not sure. But if it pops up at some point, I'll be doing it. I decided that I wanted to challenge myself in October to read a book every day. That's 31 books in October. That's my goal. My goal is to read 31 books in October. Now, I probably won't read like a book every day on the day. Some days I'll probably read more than one book, and then other days I won't have finished one. I have a lot of the short mid-grade spooky stories that I can read. I have probably seven or eight left of the Creepover series, and I also have recently hauled, and you will not have seen this haul yet, so spoiler alert. I've also hauled some of the first, I think I have five of the Sarah Normal books, which I read one of during my own spooky readathon, the Summer Scare readathon, and really enjoyed. So I hauled some more of those. And those are mid-grade and they're about 100 pages each. And then I also have the Sweep series by Kate Tiernan. I think I have like 10 of those left to read, and those are all about 175-ish pages. So I have a lot of really short, spooky books. So I figure a goal of 31 isn't terrible. And so I'm going to read those, and I am also going to try to fit in some other spooky books that I want to read, like Southern Book Club's Guide to Slaying Vampires by Grady Hendrix, and probably Where Dreams Descend by Janella Angelis, Cemetery Boys Horrid by Katrina Leno. I just got that, also spoiler alert for a haul. And then I also have a couple of books of the Nightmare series by Jason Siegel. I have a couple of those also. So I have a lot of mid-grade and then a lot of newer releases that are spooky kind of books. So I'm going to try to read 31 books in October and do some readathons. I basically just wanted to let you all know that, and hopefully you can help hold me accountable. I'm going to continue doing live reading sprints on Friday evenings. I've been doing every other Friday because Brooke typically does writing sprints every other Friday. So I've been doing reading sprints every other Friday, which, as I always say, are you're welcome to come and read, or if you like longer writing sprints, I typically do like 20 to 30 minute reading sprints, so they would be good for writing sprints. They would also be good for chores and household things and homework and whatever you need to help someone keep you focused for every other Friday. I've been working on those as well. Let me know in the comments below if you think I'm crazy. Also, if you are going to be participating in any spooky readathons for October, and let me know what your favorite spooky book is, like a book that you love to reread every year in October. Let me know, because I need to add more spooky books to my TBR because I'm going to read 31 of them this month, which means I'm going to need more for next year. So tell me all of your spooky books. That is all I have for today. I post reading, writing, and book-related videos on Mondays, Wednesdays, and bonus videos on the weekends. If you don't want to miss anything I have going on in the future, make sure you subscribe. And until then, I will see you guys next time. Bye!